Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to see an interesting topic, that is conservation of plants and animals. Before going to my topic, please like it, share it and subscribe it. Now, what is meaning of conservation? Conservation is nothing but saving them for the future. Now, we will see the basic tips for deforestation and its causes. First of all, what is deforestation? Deforestation is nothing but cutting down of trees is known as deforestation. And its causes, what are the causes? Procuring land for cultivation. We will clear the trees and plants for our cultivation, agricultural purposes. We want to build houses for our safe shelter. So, for building houses and factories. Making furniture or using wood as fuel. Now we are getting paper also from wood only. So these are the causes and the deforestation causes. Now we will see the consequences of deforestation. I am going to read this lesson now. Pahali and Bujo recall the consequences of deforestation. They remember that deforestation increases the temperature and pollution level on the earth. If you cut the trees around you, you'll not hear some bird noise. So it led to global warming and many other features. Now, it increases the level of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. Groundwater level also gets lower. They know that deforestation disturbs the balance in nature. They were told by Professor Ahmed that if cutting of trees continues, rainfall and the fertility of the soil will decrease. So these are the consequences of for a deforestation. If we reduce the plants, the amount of carbon dioxide will increases. Groundwater will decreases. All will be decreases and some will be increases. Now we will see the lesson. What is biodiversity? Biodiversity is nothing but occurrence of innumerable number of different types of organisms and the whole range of the varieties adapted to different climates. All the animals were adapted to different regions, climates, etc., environments and areas. Wildlife sanctuary, national park and biosphere reserve are names given to the areas meant by conservation and preservation of forest and wild animals. They are saying that wildlife sanctuary, national park and biosphere reserve are the safest place for the animals. Now, biodiversity refers to the variety of living organisms in a specific area. Plants and animals of a particular area are known as the flora and the fauna of that area. If we take plant, the plant in a particular area is known as flora. If you take animal, the animal found in a particular area is called fauna. Next, endemic species are found only in a particular area. So, what is endemic? Rare species. We'll see kangaroo in Australia. Only in Australia or some other countries. Only little few are seen, but not in our India. So these are the examples for the endemic species. Endangered species are those which are facing the danger of extinction. What they are saying means, if you take elephant will live for only for 10 years, again 10 years. It can't be stay for a long life. Okay. Now we'll see Red Data Book contains a record of endangered species. Red Data Book is nothing but it will record the endangered species like elephant, which are the animals are in danger post place. They will note that name in the Red Data Book. Next one we'll see. Migration is a phenomenon of movement of a species from its own habitat to some other habitat for a particular time period every year for a specific purpose like breeding. Migration is nothing but moving from one place to another place in search of food, shelter, water and etc. This is known as migration. We should save, reuse and recycle paper to save trees, energy and water. We should save all the kinds of living things and non-living things. And we have to recycle them also. Reforestation. What is afforestation? What is deforestation? Both are same but little confusing. Reforestation is the restocking of destroyed forests by planting new trees. Reforestation is the restocking of. We are going to plant once again after the destroyed trees. This is known as reforestation. I tell what is flora and what is fauna. Endemic species. Endemic species. Species of plants and animals found exclusively in a particular area. These are not naturally found anywhere else. This is called the endemic species. Extinct species. What is meaning of extinct species? We saw what? We saw endangered species. Now, what is meaning of extinct species? That is nothing but already the animals were killed. Already the animals have been lost. For example, dodo, Indian cheetah, pink-headed duck, etc. Now, what are threatened species? Species that is liable to become extinct if it is not allowed to realize its full biotic potential by removing the cause of threat. Now we are going to see the type of threatened species. We know what is endangered species. Now we are going to see the vulnerable species. A vulnerable species is a species of animals or plants which are likely to become endangered unless something changes. Example, chinkara deer and black buck, golden langur, etc. Here, what they are saying is species that are of animals or plants are likely to be endangered unless something changes. Now, what are rare species? Species whose population are originally small and scattered in the world. They are very small. Like dino, if you take some other animal, it's found in only one particular area or a region. It's known as rare species. National parks. What are national parks? National parks are nothing but protective areas reserved exclusively for the betterment of the wildlife. This is known as national parks. Example, Hazaribagh National Park in Jharkhand, Desert National Park in Rajasthan, etc. And Kaziranga Park also found in Assam. These are the few points or examples. Sanctuaries. What are sanctuaries now? These are national parks. Now, what is the meaning of sanctuaries? Sanctuaries are nothing but hunting prohibited areas set up by the government are known as sanctuaries. Now, if you see some stories, you will notice that the hunter will kill the deer or trap the deer and will kill. These are the examples, right? Now, here also same thing. Hunting is not allowed here. It was set by a government are known as sanctuaries. For example, Jaldapara in Madara Hut, West Bengal, Kilaragana in Bharatpur, Rajasthan. I told what is migration. Now we'll see what is desertification. Removal of the top layer of the soil exposes the lower hard and rocky layers. The soil has less humus and is less fertile. Gradually, the fertile land gets converted into desert. It is called desertification. These are the few points from our chapter. I explained you all the points. Now, what is recycling of paper? Now, I'm going to read this. You know recycling. What is recycling? The process of converting the waste products into useful products. If you take waste paper, we'll convert into a useful substance. It's known as recycling. Now, we are going to see the recycling of paper. Professor Ahmed draws attention of the children to another cause of deforestation. He tells them that it takes 17 full-grown trees to make 1 ton of paper. To make 1 ton of paper, you have to cut 17 full-grown trees. We have to cut 17 grown full trees. Therefore, we should save paper. Professor Ahmed also tells that paper can be recycled 5 to 7 times for use. We can recycle it for 6 to 7 times. We can recycle them into 5 to 7 times. If each student saves at least 1 sheet of paper in a day, we can save many trees in a year. Okay? Now, if we save 1 paper in a day, we can save many trees in a world. This is the main point. We should save, reuse and paper, reused paper and recycle it. By this, we not only save trees, but also save energy and water needed for manufacturing paper. Moreover, the amount of harmful chemicals used in paper making will also be reduced. This is the recycling of paper. What is reforestation? I told you that in this app. Now, what is reforestation? Once again, I'm going to teach you. Reforestation is restocking of the destroyed forest by planting new trees. This is known as reforestation. Okay, guys, we will wind up here. Thank you for watching our channel. Please like it, share it, and subscribe it. This is Study and Fun 100%. Thank you.